all clear from here to Los Angeles.
We've hit a few delays, but you'll get your precious cargo by tomorrow.
Tomorrow? But the big opening of my new restaurant is tonight. How can I offer the real Italian cuisine without my real Italian spaghetti? Spaghetti is how Italian people say spaghetti.
We'll get you your pasta. You heard the man. Set this boat's controls to faster.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Ah, I see how it is. Want to play a game of chicken, huh?
I don't think this is a good idea, Margo.
Cram it, Skip. Those limp dicks are about to find out what savvy film and television viewers have known for years. Character actress Margo Martindale ain't afraid of nothing!
No! The boats are tearing each other apart! Crates and crates of spaghetti are pouring out into the ocean!
I'm watching the same boat collision you are. You don't need to narrate it.
Oh, no!
Skippy! He was too pure for this world!
Oh, no! The pasta is cooking!
Disaster al dente off the coast of San Clemente. 12 tons of pasta have leaked into the ocean, and the massive cargo load is heading straight to Pacific Ocean City. Joining us via Google Hangout is spaghetti scientist Carla Hall. What can you tell us, Carla?
Well, Tom, as the spaghetti cooked, smothering the town and tenderly broiling the sea life who reside there.
Is there any way to prevent this delicious-sounding environmental catastrophe?
The only hope for rescue would be if someone had an enormous quantity of spaghetti strainers just sitting around the house. But that person would also need access to a fleet of drivers to transport said spaghetti strainers. And in order to strain the spaghetti fast enough, the drivers would also need to be incredibly strong swimmers. Like, just as an example, hot sexy killer whales.
Is there such a savior who could possibly fit that ridiculously specific set of criteria?
I don't know, Tom, but as they used to say on my favorite TV show, let's find out.
A movie during the day? Dare I?